the special sauce to make COVID-19 vaccines effective. In vaccine research, different approaches can be used to provide protection against infection. However, these approaches require a component to prime the immune system. The primer is called the adjuvant, a special formula found in some vaccines. Gregory Glenn, President of Research and Development at Novavax, said, "The definition of an adjuvant is something you add to enhance, in the case of immunity, the immune response." According to the US CDC, the purpose of adjuvants is to induce a better immune response in people receiving such vaccines. It is the reason why certain vaccines can work in people with compromised or weakened immune systems. However, its use is optional due to observed drawbacks: better immune response, higher risk of adverse reactions. Texas-based news group Kera News reported that adjuvants could further improve COVID-19 vaccines. Glenn explained that as primers, adjuvants would prep the immune system, particularly the dendritic cells. As messengers of innate and adaptive immunity, dendritic cells respond to foreign matter and pathogens. They would take a sample or the antigen material, present it to other immune cells, and alert the production of antibodies. Adjuvants alarm dendritic cells to ensure an immune response and antibody activity. This reduces the chance of vaccine response failure, especially in older adults and those with compromised immune systems. Novavax already tested adjuvant involvement in its vaccine and it looked promising. Here is the problem: there are not many adjuvants available. Scientists may offer adjuvants to meet the demands for faster response, better response, and long-lasting response against COVID-19. But doing so raises the risk of localized reactions, such as redness and swelling at the injection site, and systemic reactions like fever, body pain, and chills. Corey Casper, CEO of the Infectious Disease Research Institute in Seattle, cited the shingles vaccine developed by GlaxoSmithKline. That vaccine featured a powerful adjuvant to stimulate an excellent immune response. Its initial performance was 50%, but the adjuvant surged it to 97%. The boosted vaccine could even induce immune responses from elderly. Unfortunately, many people who received that shingles vaccine complained of unpleasant side effects. One series of side effects consisted of fever, inflammation, and a general feeling of unwell, which are symptoms of the disease. The symptoms appear due to the activation of immune cells. Vaccine developers tend to face issues with adjuvant because many companies do not want to share their technology with others.